Welcome to this instruction video. In this video I will explain how you can make the Eve's Sunflowers blanket. This blanket is designed by Catherine Bly and consists of different elements. I have permission from Catherine herself to explain this beautiful blanket to you. Catherine, thank you so much. If you want to go to her site or blog, then click on the link below my video. Here you find also the written pattern. The yarn that I use is cotton 8 from Scheepjes and I use a crochet hook from 3.5 mm. I hope you like this tutorial and we're going to start. In part 1 we make the central square ring of fire of the Eve's sunflower. Round 1, and we start with a magic circle. Pick up your thread and pick up and pull through. Then close the magic ring a little bit that your ring is not too big to work in it. Okay, we start with chain 3. 1, 2, and 3, and this 3 chain stitches counts for your first double crochet. In a magic circle we're gonna make 11 double crochet. Yarn over with your hook into that magic circle, pick up your thread, 3 loops on your hook, yarn over, pull through 2, and yarn over, pull through 2. This is your first double crochet. We need 10 more double crochets. This is 1, 2, 3. I make 11 double crochet and with your first chain 3 stitches you have in total 12 double crochets. Then pull to the beginning yarn and tight to close the circle and then make a slip stitch in the third chain, 1, 2, and 3, and I hope you can see it's black yarn. In the third chain stitch, enter your hook and make a slip stitch to close this round. In total, you have 12 double crochet. Round 2, begin with chain 3, 1, 2, and 3, and then in the same stitch you make a double crochet. Go back in that same stitch for a double crochet. Your first 3 chain stitches counts for your first double crochet and the second double crochet is in that same stitch. Now we're gonna begin on the repeat from this round. Chain 1 and then make 2 double crochets in the next stitch. Let's move over to the next stitch and make in same stitch 2 double crochet. It's 1 and 2, and this is the repeat you make all the way around. I show you the repeat once more. Chain 1 and then in the next stitch 2 double crochet. 1 and in that same stitch 2 double crochet all the way around. And when we close this round, I make an invisible join. The last 2 double crochet. In total, you have 24 double crochets and 12 chain stitches, chain 1 stitches. In total, 36 stitches. Now we're going to make an invisible join. Cut your yarn and pull up your thread. And then with a needle, make the invisible join. This is your first 3 chain stitches. Don't skip that. And then in the first double crochet, above that first double crochet, in that stitch on the top of that double crochet, in that whole stitch from the front to the back, put your needle in and pull through. Then you go back to the last double crochet, and in the top, in that stitch from that last double crochet, you put your needle in the top, in the middle of the stitch, and pull through. And we have now make an invisible join. Wave your threads on the back of your work, and then we're going to start with a new color. Round 3. In this round, you will be working into a chain 1 space only. The new color is on my hook, and we begin with a standing 4 double crochet cluster in any chain 1 space. Yarn over. Pick 1 chain space, enter your hook, grab your yarn, 3 loops on your hook, yarn over, pull through 2 loops, but then stop. We make those double crochet not complete. Yarn over, go back into that same chain 1 space, pick your thread, yarn over and pull through 2 loops. Once more, yarn over, in that same space, yarn over and pull through 2 loops. And once more, yarn over, in that same space, yarn over and pull through 2 loops. You have now 5 loops on your hook. Yarn over and go to all your 5 stitches. And that's a 4 double crochet cluster. Now we start with the repeat of this round. Chain 3. 1, 2 and 3. Skip 2 stitches, and then in the next chain 1 space, a new 4 double crochet cluster. Yarn over, in the next chain 1 space, pick up your thread, yarn over and pull through 2. Yarn over, in that same space, pick up, yarn over, pull through 2. Yarn over, in that same space, yarn over and pull through 2. And once more, yarn over, in that same space, yarn over and pull through 2. 5 loops on your hook, yarn over and pull through all of your loops. And this is the repeat you make 10 more times. Chain 3 and then skip the next two stitches, and then in the next chain one space, 4 double crochet cluster. I show you the repeat once more. Chain 3, 1, 2, 3, and in the next chain, 1 space and 4 double crochet cluster. This is 1, 2 times, and 3 times, and the last one, 4 times, 5 loops on your hook, yarn over and pull through all of the 5 loops. Go so all the way around, 12 clusters in total, and 12 times 3 chain stitches. The last 4 double crochet cluster. Then we make 3 chain stitches, 1, 2, and 3. And then make a slip stitch in the beginning of the 4 double crochet cluster. In the top of that, we go to the cluster, and in the top stitch, the first top stitch here, we make a slip stitch to close this round. Round 4, in this round you'll be working only in the chain 3 spaces. To start in the first chain 3 space, we make a slip stitch in that space. Now we start in the middle of that space. Chain 3, 1, 2, and 3. And then a 2 double crochet cluster. Yarn over in that space, yarn over, and pull through 2. Once more. Yarn over in that space, yarn over and pull through 2. Yarn over in that space, yarn over, pull through 2. Now you have 3 loops on your hook, yarn over and pull through all of the 3 loops. Those 2 double crochets with those 3 chain stitches, that counts as a 1 3 double crochet cluster. Then chain 3, 1, 2, and 3, and then in that same stitch, in that chain 3 stitch space, we make a new 3 double crochet cluster in that same space. 1, 2, and 3 times. 4 loops on your hook, yarn over and pull through all of your 4 loops. Now I'm going to start with the repeat for all the way around. Chain 1, and in the next chain 3 space, and it's that space, we make a 3 double crochet cluster, chain 3, and a 3 double crochet cluster. So yarn over and in that next space a 3 double crochet cluster. 1, 2, and 3 four loops on your hook, yarn over and all off. Then chain 3, 1, 2 and 3, and then in that same space a new 3 double crochet cluster. Spun. And 2 and 3. Yarn over and go all off. This is the repeat you make all the way around. Repeat 10 more times. I'll show you the repeat once more. Chain 1 and skip to the next 3 chain space and make a new 3 double crochet cluster. 1, 2 and 3. Yarn over and pull through all of your loops. Then chain 3, 1, 2 and 3. And then in the same space a 3 double crochet cluster. 1, 2 and 3. Yarn over and go all of your stitches. Go so all the way around. Last cluster. Then chain 1 and cut your yarn and make an invisible join in the first cluster stitch. This is your first cluster, and in the top of that first cluster you make an invisible join. To your last single crochet, that single crochet in the top of it, an invisible join. Round 5, and in this round we work only in the chain 3 spaces. New colors on my hook, and we start with a double crochet, a standing double crochet in any chain 3 space. Then in that same space, 1 double crochet. Chain 4, 1, 2, 3 and 4, and in the same space go back with 2 double crochets. Now we start the repeat from this round. In the next space, chain 3 space, we make 2 double crochet, chain 4 and 2 double crochet. Yarn over and go to the next space and make a double crochet. And a double crochet. Then chain 4, 1, 2, 3 and 4, and back in that same space with two double crochets. This is one and two. This is the repeat. You go all the way around. Repeat 10 times more. I'll show you the repeat once more. Yarn over and go to the next chain 3 space and make 2 double crochets. One and two, then chain 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4, and back in that same space with 2 double crochet. Go so all the way around, and then in the to close this round, you make an invisible join in the beginning of that standing double crochet. I'm closing this round with an invisible join in the first standing double crochet. Now we have 48 double crochets, 12 chain 4 stitches, and that makes 96 stitches in total. Round 6, and in this round we work only in the chain 4 spaces with a new color. We make a standing double crochet in any chain 4 space. Now in that same space we make 3 double crochets. One, two, and three. With your first standing double crochet, you make 4 double crochets. Then chain 2, 1 and 2, and then go back in that same chain 4 space with 4 double crochets. One, two, three, and four. Now I'm start with the repeat from this round. Skip over to the next chain 4 space. And in that space we make 4 double crochets, chain 2 and 4 double crochet, all in that same space. 4 double crochets, this one, 2, 3 and 4, then chain 2 and 4 more double crochets in that same space. 1, 2, 3 and 4. This is the repeat you make all the way around. 10 more times. I'll show you the repeat once more in the next chain 4 stitches. 4 double crochets in that next chain 4 stitch chain space. This 2, 3 and 4, chain 2 and 4 double crochet, all in that same space. all the way around, 12 in total. And then you here in the begin, you make an invisible join in the beginning of the first standing double crochet to close this round. I'm closing this round with an invisible join in the first standing double crochet. Now we have 96 double crochets, 12 two chain stitches, and that makes in total 120 stitches. Round 7. In this round we work behind round 6 between sets of the two double crochet from round 5. And I mean in this space here, over this stitch, and then behind round 6 we work in this space here. Fold your petals down, and then behind those petals in this space here we begin with a new color, with a standing treble DC. Twice over on your hook, and then in those space here we work a standing treble crochet. And then you fold your petals back, then you see here the stitch, you work in it. In that same space you'll work 3 treble crochets. Yarn twice over, go back in that same space and work a treble crochet. Yarn twice over and go back in that same space and work a treble crochet, and one more twice over in that same space a treble crochet. Four trebles, then chain 2 and go back in that same space with 4 treble crochets. It's 1 and 2. And the last one, 4. When you fold your petals back, then it looks like this. Skip the next petal from round 6 and work in the next space around round 5. We start with the repeat from this round. Skip the petal, move your petals to the front, and in this space here you work the repeat from this round, 4 treble crochets. This is 1, 2, 3, and 4, chain 2 and in that same space 4 treble crochets. One, two, three, and four. Repeat this 10 times all the way around, and when you in the beginning of this round we close this round with an invisible join in the first standing treble crochet. I'm done with this round and I make an invisible join in the first standing treble crochet, and now when we unfold the petals of round 6, then it looks like this. Round 8, new color is on my hook, and we begin with a standing single crochet in any chain 2 space from round 7. Standing single crochet. Chain 3, 1, 2, and 3, and in that same space, a single crochet. Now we make a back post single crochet in the next 3 stitches around the post of the next 3 trebles from the back of your work. Enter your hook to the front, and the front to the back, around the post, around the treble. And then on the back of your work you make a single crochet. In the next stitch, a back post single crochet. And in the next stitch also a back post single crochet. Then in the next 2 stitches, a back post single crochet from the back to the front, around the post of the treble, and then skip over to the next treble, from the front to the back, and on the back of your work you make a single crochet. Now you have made a back post single crochet around 2 stitches. Then in the next 3 stitches, a back post single crochet. That's 1, 2. And 3. Then in the next chain 2 space you work a single crochet, chain 3, and back in that same space with a single crochet. And this is the repeat you can make all the way around. I'll show you the repeat once more. in the next 3 stitches, a single crochet back post. One, two, three, and back post single crochet in the next 2 stitches. And back post single crochet in the next 3 stitches. Two, three, and then in the next chain 2 space a single crochet, chain 3, and a single crochet in that same space. Go so all the way around, and before we close this round, I will come back to you and let's see how we close this round. The last stitches. I'm all the way around and we close this round with a slip stitch in the first standing single crochet. Slip stitch to close this round. Now we have 24 single crochets, 84 back post single crochets, 12 chain 3 stitches, and that's in total 144 stitches. Round 9, and we make a slip stitch into the chain 3 space here, a slip stitch, to start in that chain 3 space, chain 3, 1, 2 and 3, and in this space we make 4 double crochet, 1, 2, 3, and 4. With the first chain 3 stitches you make 5 double crochets, then chain 2 and back in that same space with 5 double crochets, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Now we make the repeat from this round, the petal of round 6 in the chain 2 space. You go in with your needle, then go back to round 8 and skip 4 stitches from round 8. This is 1, 2, 3, and 4. And in the fifth stitch, this stitch here, and then only in the front loop. In this loop here, and it should be above your fourth back post single crochet. In that front loop, you go in and make a a single crochet. It look like this. Skip 4 stitches, 1, 2, 3 and 4, and then we come here in those little loop here in that chain 3 space, and we make in those space 5 double crochets. 5, chain 2, and in that same space 5 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And this is the repeat you can make all the way around. I'll show you the repeat once more. The petal of round 6 in that chain 2 space. You can go in with your needle. Then skip 4 stitches from round 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, and in the 5th stitches here, only in the front loop, you pick up a loop, pull through, and make a single crochet. Now skip the next 4 stitches, 1, 2, and 3, and 4, and then here in that chain 3 space, we work 5 double crochets. 1, 2, and 3, 4, and 5. Chain 2 and 5 double crochet, all in that same stitch space. Go so all the way around. Now we're on the last stitches of this round. Skip the next 4 stitches, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then in stitch number 5 we're gonna not enter the hook in that whole stitch, but only in the front loop, and I pull the loop a little bit up that you can see which stitch I mean. This stitch here. Then go with your hook to the petal, enter your hook in that chain 2 space, and put your needle in that loop of round 8 and make a single crochet. Now cut the yarn. Open up your stitch and make an invisible join to close this round. This is your first 3 chain stitches. We skip those, and in the first double crochet in that stitch on the top of that double crochet, you make an invisible join to close this round. go back to the last single crochet. Weave your tail in to the back of your work and we're gonna start with a new color. Round 10. In round 9 we worked in the front loops of a single crochet. This is the single crochet that we make in the only front loops of this stitch here. In this round we work in the back loop of that same stitch and it's this stitch here. This is the front loop and this is the back loop of that stitch. I had a new color on my yarn and we begin with a standing treble in that stitch, in that back loop stitch. Like this. Now in that same stitch, 3 treble crochets. One, two, and three. Then chain 2 and go back in that same tiny stitch here with 4 treble crochets. This is 1, 2, three, and the last one, 4. Now we start with the repeat of this round. Chain 1 and skip the next petal and move over to the next single crochet here and then in the back loop from that stitch. Dus here we make a single crochet in the front loop and now we're gonna make DC of treble stitches in the back loop of that stitch. 4 treble crochet in that stitch. That's 1. And 2. Three and 4, then chain 2 and 4 treble crochet in that same stitch. One, 2. Three and 4. And this is the repeat that you go all the way around 10 more times and then we close this round with an invisible join in the beginning of the first standing treble crochet. And now we have in total 69 treble crochets, 12 chain 2 stitches and 12 chain 1 stitches. That is a total of 132 stitches in total. Round 11, and in this round we only work in the chain 1 space of round 10. New color is on my hook, and we start with a treble crochet in a chain 1 space of round 10. A standing treble crochet. Now in that same space we make 4 treble crochets in that same space. This 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 trebles in total. Chain 2, and then back in that same space with 5 treble crochet. One, two, three, four, and five. This is your new petal. Now skip 10 stitches, and that is the petal from round 10. And then in the next chain 1 space we make 5 treble crochet, and this is the repeat from round 11. 5 treble crochet in that next chain 1 space. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, five, chain 2, and 5 trebles in that same space. 1, 2, three, four, and 5 treble crochet. This is the repeat. Goes all the way around. Repeat this 10 more times, and then make an invisible join in the beginning of that first standing treble crochet. Now you have 120 treble crochets, 12 chain 2 stitches, and that's 144 stitches in total. Round 12, with a new color, we start with a standing single crochet in any chain 2 space of round 11. 2 chain space, and we start with a single standing single crochet. Chain 3, and in that same stitch, in that same space, you worked one single crochet. Now we're beginning with the repeat of this round. In the next 4 stitches, we make a back post single crochet. So around the post, back post and single crochet 4 times. So 1, and then in the next stitch, 2 and 3 and 4. Then in the next 2 stitches we worked a back post single crochet and then 2 stitches together, just from the back to the front, and then in the next stitch here on the front to the back and work a single crochet on the back of that 2 stitches. In the next 4 stitches, a back post single crochet. 1, 2, and 4, and then in the next chain 2 space a single crochet, chain 3, and in that same stitch a single crochet. And this is the repeat. You can work all the way around 11 times. And when we close this round, we join with a slip stitch in the stitch of the first standing single crochet. The last 4 stitches of this round. And we close this round with a slip stitch in the first standing single crochet. Don't cut the yarn. In the next round we use the same color. Now I have lots of markers in my work, and those markers help me for round 14. And I show you where you put your markers in. This is a repeat, and here's your chain 3 space, and then you have a single crochet, and then in the first back post single crochet in that stitch you put a marker in. And then go back to the other side. Here's your chain 3 space, and then here is your single crochet, and then skip over to the first or the last back post single crochet in that stitch. You put also a marker. Go so all the way around, and those markers help you in round 14. Round 13, and we begin with a slip stitch in the first chain 3 space. So we start in that chain 3 space. Chain 3, and your first chain 3 stitches are counting for the first double crochet. in that same space, you work 4 double crochets. And oh my dear, we had lots of noise of all my stitch markers in my work. Sorry. Then chain 3, 1, 2 and 3, and in that same chain 3 space we worked 5 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Now we skip 5 stitches. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and in the next stitch, and that which should be the 5th back post single crochet from round 12. In that stitch you work 3 double crochets. Three double crochets. Work a 3 double crochet cluster in the chain 2 space from round 10. And is this space here from round 10. Yarn twice over, then go to round 10. Pick up your yarn. Yarn over, pull through 2 loops. Yarn over, pull through 2 loops. And now stop. Make those treble knot complete. Yarn over twice and go back in that same space. Pick your yarn. Yarn over, pull through 2 loops. And yarn over, pull through 2 loops. Then we stop again, twice over, go back in that same loop, same space, pick up your yarn, yarn over, pull through 2 loops, and yarn over and pull through 2 loops. Now you have 4 loops on your hook, yarn over and go all of your 4 loops to make those treble together. And now we work that 3 double crochet in that stitch here. In that same stitch we make another 3 double crochets in that same stitch. It's 1, 2 and 3. Here's your cluster from the 3 trebles, and on the back of your work you made 6 double crochets in that same stitch. Skip the next 5 stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. And then in the next chain 3 space we work 4 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, then chain 2, 1 and 2, and back in that same stitch with 4 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Here you have 5 double crochets with between 3 chain stitches, and here you have 4 double crochets with 2 chain stitches, and skip 5 stitches, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and then in the next stitch, and that is the stitch, 5th stitch of the back post single crochet from round 12. In that stitch you work 3 double crochets, one, two, and three. Now work a cluster of 3 treble crochet together in the space, in the chain 2 space from round 10. Yarn over twice, go to the space of round 10 and make a cluster of 3 trebles together. It's 1, 2, and 3. 4 loops on your hook, yarn over and go to all of your 4 loops. Then in that same stitch where you make the 3 double crochets, in that same stitch work also 3 double crochets in that same stitch. So work 6 double crochets in that same stitch. Now skip 5 stitches, and then in the next chain 3 space we work 4 double crochets, 1, 2, 3, and 4, then chain 2, and in that same space 4 double crochet. Skip 5 stitches, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and in the next stitch we worked 3 double crochet, 1, 2, and 3. Then in the leaf from round 10, in that chain 3 space, we work a treble cluster, 3 together. It's 1, 2, and 3, 4 loops on your hook, yarn over and pull through all your loops. And then in the same stitch where you make the 3 double crochets, in that same stitch 3 double crochets in that same stitch. Skip 5 stitches, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and then in the next 3 chain loop. We make 5 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Then chain 3 and go back in that same space with 5 double crochets. And now we have 2 leaves of 5 double crochets, chain 3 and 5 double crochets, and 2 leaves of 4 double crochets and 2 chain stitches. Go so all the way around and make an invisible join in the first leaf here with a needle. This round I'm closing with an invisible join, and when we look to the flower, we made 4 petals. These 4 petals of 5 double crochets, chain 3 and 5 double crochets, and 8 petals of 4 double crochets, chain 2 and 4 double crochets. Round 14, and in this round we begin with a new color in a 3 chain corner space. Begin with a standing double crochet in that 3 chain corner space, and we make there a new corner. We start with 2 double crochets. That's 1 and 2, then chain 3, 1, 2 and 3, and back in that same space with 3 double crochets. 1, 2 and 3. This is your first new corner. Then a back post double crochet in the next 5 stitches around the post of this 5 double crochets. Yarn over and then around those double crochet and back post, and make a double crochet on the back of the stitch. Five times in total is 2, round the post and back post double crochet, 3, 4, and the last one, 5. Now we work in round 13, and we flip our work to the front, and we see here those markers, and in the marker, that's the point that we're working in. We make a back post double crochet in the next 2 stitches. Yarn twice over and then go to the stitch from the marker, and in those stitch we make a treble crochet. Yarn twice over, and then in the stitch next to the marker, in those stitch, a treble crochet. And now we're working into round 12 behind round 13, and that's our, we put our markers in. In that first stitch from your marker, we make a treble crochet, and in the next stitch we work also a treble crochet. So yarn twice over for a treble, and go in that stitch of your first marker here, go in that stitch and make a treble crochet. And in the next stitch, next to the marker, this is the marker stitch, and then in the next stitch, a treble crochet. And now the marker can out of your work. And now we work a front post single crochet around the three treble crochet cluster. This is the cluster you make, and around those cluster in the front post, around those cluster here, we make a single crochet. Front post. And now we going back to round 12, and in the next two stitches we work a treble crochet, and that's in the stitch of the marker and the stitch for the marker. There we work two treble crochets. Yarn over, and then in the stitch for the marker stitch, we work a treble crochet. And in the stitch from the marker, also a treble crochet. And I remove those marker, and now we work in the next leaf from round 12 in the next two stitches, those stitches, a back post double crochet around the next two stitches. So around the post, on the back of your work, a double crochet. And in the next stitch, a double crochet back post. In the next two stitches, and back post, half double crochet. So around the post, on the back of your work, and half double crochet. And in the next stitch, and back post, half double crochet. And in that chain 2 space, a single crochet. In the next 2 stitches, a back post, half double crochet. That's one. And in the next, this. So, and in the next 2 stitches, a back post double crochet. One and two. Now we skip over to the next 2 markers, and in your first marker, in this stitch here, you work a treble crochet, and in the next stitch also a treble crochet. Yarn over for your treble and then go in the stitch of the marker and make a treble crochet. And then also in the next stitch after the marker a treble crochet. Then go to the cluster, treble cluster, and around those cluster we make a front post single crochet. And then we go to the next marker stitch, around 12, and in the marker stitch we make a treble stitch, treble crochet, and in the stitch for the marker we make also a treble crochet. In the stitch for the marker and treble, and in the stitch of the marker also a treble crochet. And I remove the markers . Now you're working in the next leaf. In the next 2 stitches, a back post double crochet. One, and in the next stitch around the post and back post double crochet. In the next 2 stitches and back post half double crochet. The first one and the second one, and then in the corner chain 2 space and single crochet, and then in the next 2 stitches a back post half double crochet, it's one and two, and in the next 2 stitches a back post double crochet, one and two. And now we're gonna work in round 12 in the stitches of the next marker. In the marker stitch and in the stitch after the marker we work 2 times a treble crochet. Yarn twice over and go to that marker stitch, and in this marker stitch we make a treble crochet. And into the next stitch after the marker a treble crochet. Then in the treble cluster we make a front post single crochet. So round those cluster, on the front post and make a single crochet. And now we skip over to round 12 on the two stitches from the marker, and in the stitch for the marker stitch we make a treble crochet, and in the stitch of the marker himself also a treble crochet. This one, and then in the stitch of the marker a treble crochet. And those marker go out of your work. And now we skip over to the parallel of the corner. In the next 5 stitches we make a back post double crochet. So round those double crochet on the back of your work and double crochet 5 times, spun. And 3 4 and 5. Then in the corner chain 3 space we make a new corner, 3 double crochets, 1, 2, and 3. Then chain 3, and then in the same corner space we work 3 double crochets, 1, 2, and 3. And this corner is the same corner as this corner. Repeat all those stitches 3 times all the way around and close with an invisible join this round.